Oh, I've been waiting for this. Some of you have been waiting for this too. There's a story behind this box. What's inside this box? How did it get here? Oh man, I can't wait to show you it. Let's dive into this. Homesteading's really all about chickens, right? I mean, when it comes down to it, we're really just all trying to find ways that we can feed our chickens. Pretty simple, right? This box comes from the West Coast. From a homestead, a family who is trying to feed their chickens and has partnered up with Homesteady to help us make our dreams and our inspirations and our pictures in the night reality so that they can feed their chickens. You see, over a month ago, I was preparing to launch the Homesteady Camel Train. We were purchasing camels. I was going to start this very special program where people get a lifetime Homesteady Pioneer membership, all access to all our content for life, our courses, our classes, the discounts. And I wanted something special for those people so they could remember that they helped us start our camel dairy. And I came up with the idea of a shirt that had not only the camel got camel milk on it, but 100 camels in our camel train. And when someone bought the camel train ticket, their one little camel would be the exact number they were. It would be highlighted in gold to remind them when they join the camel train. Well, today we get to see it. We get to pop this open. But first I want you to see the story behind this box. I want you to travel to a homestead across the country, a family who helps us make these little ideas that I think of in the middle of the night. It was like 2 a.m. and I was drawing pictures of t-shirts on a notepad because that's how my brain works. And now it's here. It's actually reality. I can't wait to open it. But first, let's go check out the Parson Homestead.
Hey guys, we're the Parsons, you know, the ones that print the t-shirts for Homesteady. So we're here on our homestead before we go to the shop, and we're going to talk about the things that we got to get done. So what do we got to do today?
We're going to clean out the coop, get the chickens some fresh shavings.
Mm-hmm. Hopefully we get some eggs.
Yes. Laying a little bit. We need to start laying out plans for our raised beds, even though we're a little late. Better late than never.
Yeah, I'd love to get some vegetables this year. That'd be awesome.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What else?
It snowed last night, but the grass does need to be cut, but I don't know, I'm gonna have to wait.
Guess we'll see. Mm-hmm. Alright, let's get to it.
Let's do it.
Alright, some of our chickens jump right over the fence and they just run all over our yard, and I have to clean the driveway a lot. So we'll let the ones in because they're standing all around. They're like, feed me, feed me. Hey, you gotta talk about this food that you make.
Well,
she makes this chicken food. Check this out.
This one's not mixed yet, though.
Huh.
Well, I'll just take the critter mix from our grocery store bulk food, which has like sunflower seeds and corn, and mix it with mealworms. So it was a little cheaper than getting a pre-mixed mealworm treat for the chickens.
You guys gotta find those inexpensive deals to take care of your flock.
I like the corn the best.
So this little 8x10, I think it is, shed was already on the property when we bought it. We've only been here for probably, I think, 2 years now, right? You know, time flies. 2 years in July, we've lived on this, our homestead that we're building. And we got this whole space on our 1 acre lot that behind me here, that where the chicken tractors are over there. And we're just surrounded by these beautiful fields. So nothing but just green lands, and our neighbors have sheep. We hear the coyotes at night, which I haven't got one yet, or hadn't had one get into the chicken coop, but they get the neighbors. The coyotes kind of are hanging out at bay somewhere out here on the back of the property, and from our second story deck of our room, I go out at night and I kind of hope that I can get one. But they got a couple of our neighbors' sheep, and so they've been hanging out at night, flying the drone, trying to catch them, but everyone's just on full alert, watching out for each other, make sure that we don't lose any more sheep from their place. But the community out here for home studies in Oregon is pretty cool. We work with some people that have cattle, and so we buy our beef from them. And we actually have a group of friends of ours that the last 2 years that we did our chicken tractors back there, we built those with them, and we did the 50 chickens the first year, and then I think we did 30 this time. And oh man, it's so delicious to do fresh meat chickens. I will never go back to grocery store chickens or eggs again. Oh, I'm so glad we did this. But it was really good to try it the first year and have our friends come out with us, and they bought half the chickens, and so now we have this community of friends that live in town, and they have a few chickens in a small town. They're allowed to have some on their property. But not nearly as many as we can out here in the country, and it's not that far away. But the laws are different out here. So we said, hey, if anyone wants to go in with us, and if you come help butcher, we'll definitely do the chicken. So we have this big butcher day with a bunch of friends, and I have something really cool to show you. I told Austin about that we got this year that we haven't got to try yet until we this year's butchering, which I'm stoked to use this new thing that I'll unveil for you here before we go to the print shop. But in the meantime, let's take care of our homestead today. It's a beautiful day. I can't believe it snowed yesterday, because it doesn't even, you can't even tell. Funny. But all right, let's get to work. On top of setting up cameras to try to get something done today and show you guys how it's done, we also have kids. We have three of them. Our youngest one here, who just woke up from nap, so all the time we were trying to get stuff done, we were trying to do it before he woke up. But now we got a little helper. The other two I encouraged to come out here, but they're inside on this beautiful day being lazy bums, still in their PJs. And so we got one helper today. All right, let's finish our job. Said I was gonna unveil something that we got. Some of you probably guessed what it was, a new machine for our farm. Well, we got a chicken plucker. I'm so excited about this. I can't wait to use it, because like I said, I think in one of the first videos when
Austin introduced us, the one waiting the year to show the t-shirt stuff. We were thinking about this thing and it came on sale, and my friend who we do the Kinas, or who we do our farming with, which I'd love to show them in a video of us using this thing. It's just gonna speed up 15 seconds. Oh, it took us 10 hours to do 50 chickens. So I'm so excited for this, and hopefully I get the chance to show you. If you haven't got one or have one, I've seen them on YouTube before and we were totally sold on it. So hopefully it works as well as we've seen other people do it.
Well, that's enough for today. It's starting to get cold outside. It's getting late. We're gonna go inside and watch some home study videos, make dinner and sit by the fire where it's nice and warm. It is really pretty today, but it's cold. So I just wanted to share with you too is, like, we never feel like this is something that we have to do. It feels like something we get to do. It's actually kind of relaxing. The fruits of our labor we enjoy when we get to eat our chickens and share that time with dinner with our family and stuff like that. So the homesteady lifestyle and all the content that Austin puts out is pretty good. And homesteady has been a great resource for all that information that we get. And we are so proud to be the printing partners for homesteady. So let's go print us some Camel Train t-shirts. Hey guys, well, welcome to Parsons Line Shop. Here's our screen printing press. I actually got the front screen done already. So we're gonna go ahead and head over to our dark room and I'll show you the process of, hey, you guys hear that? Listen, that's a Camel Train. Our shop is literally located right on the side of a train track. Hear that? I hope you heard that, because that's the Camel Train. Ever since Austin launched the first video, I was like, I'm gonna yell Camel Train every time that thing goes by. So I have. So back to the dark room, let's go check it out and I'll show you how this screen press gets set up. So this is the film and the exposure table. And 100 camels. This is the screen we're gonna use. So we'll measure it, set this in place. I still hear the Camel Train. It's literally shaking the building right now. What perfect timing to have a Camel Train shirt and a real train go by. So this thing's like a big giant canning bed with a vacuum table on top. Throw that in there. Here we go. First thing we gotta do is spray a little pallet adhesive spray on the boards to keep the shirts in place when we print. Okay, before we actually put this on the final shirt or the customer product, we got tons of little test shirts laying around that maybe had a misprint or a hole or something like that in it, and they just sent us new ones to replace the defects and stuff. But anyways, there's so many logos on there, and so we just keep filling it up till the shirt's full and we use it for a test rag and then toss it out. But we'll set up on one of these little tank top here, and we're doing this in a gold metallic shimmer, so I'm excited to see what this looks like. We don't print with this one very much. Usually we do a lot of silver, but let's see how that looks on this black. Because now we need to take our printing squeegee. And I've got the ink on the screen, and we'll just run it over this. This takes a while to master, a few thousand prints, especially with the color white, to really get a good print, depending on how the angle is. So it's crucial to get that right to get a good quality print. Ooh, that's right. Gold. Now we can take our test print off looks like it's gonna work. We'll run it through our final dry over here. And this has an infrared heater unit, which will cure the ink and kind of harden it and grab the fibers of the shirt. And that's how most of the stuff that you guys are probably wearing or have got or ordered already, even if other print shops, it just grabs onto the fibers with the plastic of the ink, and that just dries it. So let me seize this opportunity to introduce you to Bryant. It's my brother-in-law. He's normally behind the camera for all the stuff we do here at Parsons Designs, but he always runs this thing every day. He's runs this press while I'm on the phone or on the computer taking orders or setting up designs and logos. So that's what he does, and the cameras. We're gonna put our heads together and try to figure out the smoothest way to put all these camels on the back of individual shirts, because this is a new process for us. So what are your ideas?
So basically, I think we're just gonna be taping one of these off for every shirt, so we'll have a space left where that camel is.
Okay.
And then we'll bring our other row of camels over and just move it into that space, and take the other ones off, so we leave one camel, and then just do a couple swipes of gold there and should have a gold camel.
All right,
that's what I'm thinking.
I'm gonna throw a test shirt. Let's give it a shot.
Okay.
So I made these perfect little 1-inch grid on my 3-inch tape and cut them all out on this grid, so we have this perfect little square to put on the back and move it, or other pieces of tape to block it off. Got ink running through there.
So we got our space for our camel here. So just gonna move this guy over, tighten that down. We're ready for a gold camel.
Yep, I'll tape off all these ones on the backside.
Clean a small tape.
So we'll just have to tape each one and move it over 100 times until we get to that last 100 camel train shirt.
First gold camel.
Woo! Oh, that's cool. All right.
Sweet.
One down, 99 to go. Okay, we decided we're gonna take the list right there that Bry has in his hands, and we're going to stack them backwards. So we got all the fronts done, which is actually the easy part. And now we're gonna work from, let's see, at this time, when we got this order, we got 62 shirts. So we're gonna work backwards so that we can actually print in order. I know that probably doesn't make any sense, but that's what we're gonna do. Then we can just go 1 through 62 at the time, and then when the other half of the order comes in, the 63 through 100. We'll have these all done hopefully within a couple weeks, and you guys will be hopefully sharing photos of your camel train shirts on Instagram, Facebook, all the shout out stuff. We'll try to follow you guys and check that out. So let's get to it. Okay, black women's large. Blue men's large, black men's 2XL, blue women's XL, black women's medium, blue women's medium, black women's large, black women's medium, red men's large, black men's 2XL, red women's extra large. All right, here's the first camel train. Looks like a shout out to Dakota. Here's your shirt, right there. You're gonna be wearing this, how cool. All right, so I gotta tape off your number one camel here.
So here's the first camel in gold. That sucker to sparkle. There we go. Alright, we'll give that a shot.
Alright, so we're kind of developing a little bit of a system here, four shirts at a time. He yells out what camel I'm supposed to tape, but you think about counting your chickens. I know you guys have done it, counting your chickens. So counting camels, little tiny camels, 100 of them, that's pretty hard. So I'm going to go home and I'm going to count my chickens and then I'm going to be a master at it after this. So here we go. We're slowly but surely making a few of them at a time, four shirts at a time progress, because there we go. As you can see behind me, there's all the camels on the camel train. So where you're finding, this is a lot like battleships because we did it in a row 10 by 10. So Bri yells, tape off camel, row 5, fourth one down, right? How are you saying that? I don't know, he says it and I just stick the piece of tape on it. And then we move on to the next camel. And that's how it's done. All right, we got the camel train shirts done, so it's time to get ready for shipping.
Beautiful is that? Got camel milk. I love it. Awesome job, Parsons. We love the new Homesteady Camel Train t-shirt. On the back, you'll see the camel train grid, 100 camels. None of my camels are gold because I'm not on the camel train. I got the camels though. But there's the camel train t-shirt. Got camel milk on the bottom, camel train on the back. And if you get it, there are still there's 10 tickets left for the camel train. So you could have one of those little golden camels on the back of this one-of-a-kind shirt. So if you wanna have one of these one-of-a-kind shirts, click there. Parsons, love it. Thank you so much for your hard work. We love working with another Homestead family who has not only like done such a good job on the product and the quality of the product, but who takes the money that they're earning from this and grows chickens and buys chicken pluckers and is living that Homesteady life. So keep it up, guys. And if you need some shirts done, the Parsons don't just handle Homesteady's work. They have an awesome t-shirt printing business. I especially like how much of a professional Aaron is. He'll tell you things you just didn't even know about t-shirts. When we were trying to design this, he initially was concerned that the milk jug on the front, he said it's a big graphic, so traditional kind of paint might feel like too much of a graphic. So he found a special kind of paint that would work in a special kind of shirt, so it's comfortable but it still will hold up over time. Hard work on the Homestead. They are awesome to work with, the Parsons Homestead. So I'm gonna have a link below if you need t-shirts done for your business. Right now their store can't have any traffic coming off from the streets. They're out on the West Coast where this virus is spreading, but they can do work over the internet. So right now we could help this family, help their business. If you need some t-shirts made for whatever you're doing, contact the Parsons, tell them hi from a Homesteady fan. Thank them for their awesome work on the Homesteady products. And if you don't need shirts, but you want to just see what they're doing on their homestead, click there. They are started a YouTube channel. So go say hi to the Parsons YouTube channel. I would like to see them get to their first 100 subscribers this week. There are thousands of people going to watch this video. Let's see if we could get them to 100 subscribers. I would love to see that. I'm gonna subscribe right now. So ready? I'm gonna open this up. Parsons. Oh, because I think it's Parsons Designs. Yes, there we go, Parsons Designs. So if you wanna check out Parsons Designs, what they're doing, there's their channel. Parsons Designs, there's their channel. You can see what they're up to behind the design. Wonderfully made.
Today on Behind the Design, we're going to take a look at Wonderfully Made Home Cleaning Services, where owners Danielle and Cammie have came up with this really cool logo for their company. Let's take a look.
So you can see how they're making their cool products. I'm going to leave a comment. Way to go, guys. They're at 16 subscribers right now. That means 74 people need to go over and click the subscribe button on their channel. So go ahead and give that a subscribe and say hello from Homesteady. Now, for those of you on the Camel Train who are like, when am I gonna get my sweet new Camel Train t-shirt? I got some good news and I got some bad news. We have a little bit of, I don't know, bad news about our Camel Train t-shirts coming in just a second. Just wait for that. First, it's time for a Homesteady Camel Train shout out. Don't worry, the bad news isn't that bad, but we'll get to that in a second. I don't want it to dampen our shout out here.
Today's Camel Train goes to Alex.
Alex, this is pretty funny. He says, I have golden cuffs. In 10 years, plus or minus a couple, Alex will be retiring. And at that point, buying a piece of land to start a homestead. So, hey, golden cuffs happen. At least they're golden.
Cuffs?
Cuffs. Like, you have a job that
like
you're gonna stick
cuffs?
To. You're making good money from. You can't retire, you can't homestead yet. I love it though, because Alex hasn't let the golden cuffs stop, prevent some homesteading from already happening. Alex is working with a friend. That friend has a piece of land.
Together they've raised some feeder chickens.
That's right, you've raised a few feeder chickens.
Turkeys, feeder turkeys.
Alex is looking at other animals for the future. So Alex, thanks for joining the Camel Train. Your one of a kind t-shirt is right there, it's on its way. And you now have lifetime access to the Homesteady Pioneer Program. A whole lot of stuff in there about other livestock to check out, so enjoy that. Now let's get back to
the bad news.
The bad news about the t-shirts. Now, for those of you on the Camel Train who are like, when am I gonna get my sweet new Camel Train t-shirt? I got some good news and I got some bad news. The good news is if you got in early, before the coronavirus really started blowing up, your shirts are printed and they're being shipped from the Parsons home because they can't go into their office right now because of everything going on with this virus. So, the good news is the first probably 50, 60 of you are getting your shirts. Stay tuned, they'll be headed your way. If you join the Camel Train a little bit later, don't worry, you're still getting your shirts. There might be a little bit of a delay because of the virus, because of them not being a business that has to be open. They can't just go in and do business if the government shut them down. So don't worry, they'll be coming. Stay tuned. And if you get on the Camel Train right now, you will have to wait a little bit for your t-shirt. Once this virus thing passes, your t-shirt will come and we'll all be able to rock our beautiful Camel Milk t-shirts. I love it. I cannot wait to wear this around town and use it to tell people about the amazing qualities of Camel Milk and how I bought camels. And I hope you use it as a cool conversation piece too. Please share it on social media, hashtag Camel Train. And I would love to see it. If I see it pop up on social media, Instagram, whatever, I'll share it. So Camel Train t-shirts, I wanna see them. Okay, we'll see you in tomorrow's video.